size it. Legalize it, yeah, yeah, and I will advertise it. Some call it
according to the NIDA, between 65 and 71 million Americans have smoked marijuana at some time in their lives, and 10 million are current smokers. Prop 215. To ensure that seriously ill Californians have the right to obtain and use marijuana for medical purposes where that medical use is deemed appropriate and has been recommended by a physician who has determined that the person's health would benefit from the use of marijuana in the treatment of cancer, anorexia, AIDS, chronic pain, spasticity, glaucoma, arthritis, migraine, or any other illness for which marijuana provides relief.
Marijuana can provide relief for patients suffering from arthritis because marijuana can control the pain and acts as an autoimmune modulator. Marijuana is a natural pain reliever and can release serotonin into the body, which helps decrease migraines. Marijuana stimulates appetite, which can help patients suffering from anorexia, and also counters HIV-related wasting, allowing AIDS patients to gain weight and prolong their lives. Marijuana reduces vomiting and nausea associated with chemotherapy, and patients find that smoking marijuana is an anti-nauseant, often more effective than mainstream medications.
For marijuana are well documented now, and more research needs to be done on this, but we know that it is a very effective treatment for nausea that's related to cancer treatment. Many of the side effects and symptoms of HIV, AIDS, multiple sclerosis, wasting syndrome, weight loss, these types of things, marijuana has been found to be a very effective treatment in these. So the medicinal uses of marijuana, we've only begun to scratch the surface of what it might be able to do. That's why good scientific peer-reviewed research is so important in this area. Well, if you look at marijuana policy reform overall, when this organization started in 1994, not one single state had a law that protected sick people who used marijuana as a medicine. Today, there are 12 states that have such laws that are effective at protecting patients and doctors, and there are several more that are poised to join those ranks. So if you want to look for direct evidence of progress in this area, I think the medical marijuana law is an excellent one.
Oh, problems are many. Many patients are being arrested anyhow and told, well, they'll have to explain it to the judge in court, which if you're really sick, that's a bummer. Many patients are having their medicine taken and not given back, and some of them are being taken to jail, some are being issued citations. Only one or two of the patients in the California that we know of have actually had the police give them their marijuana back. Usually they come up with some excuse why they can't do it.
There's still cops, police officers who will not recognize the law, that still try to enforce federal law, which California cops are not supposed to do that. We've had a major court ruling to that effect this week that says that they can't enforce federal laws, and that which caused them to give back some medicine to some patients who they had taken it away from.
Like in Bakersfield, we had 6 dispensaries operating under a license from the sheriff. And they cooperated with the DEA. They came in and closed them all down. They arrested 2 owners of 2 dispensaries. 1 dispensary, Nature's Medicinal, they claimed was doing too much. They had too many patients, they had thousands of patients, but they were operating under the direction of the Sheriff's Department legally in the state of California. And they cooperated with the DEA. And so eight of my friends, 8 good people, people were getting medicine from them. Or under federal indictment, it could do 20 years in prison.
I think it would be a boon to the economy.
There's a lot of reasons. One of the main reasons, a lot of reasons are economics.
The amount of time spent by law enforcement and the judicial system to incarcerate responsible, nonviolent marijuana users is ineffective in lowering drug use rates and is a waste of millions of the American taxpayers' dollars. The Substance Abuse and Crime Prevention Act was passed in California in 2000. The law allows first-time marijuana law offenders to choose drug treatment programs over jail.
When most people talk about decriminalizing marijuana, they're usually referring to removing criminal penalties, but not necessarily civil penalties. For example, a parking ticket is a civil violation. And so when people talk about decriminalizing marijuana, they're talking more about treating it still as a crime, but as a crime more like a parking ticket might be a crime. Little they actually do to keep our country safer or to lower drug use.
Even though marijuana has been decriminalized in California and 11 other states in America, there are still 38 states where recreational, nonviolent marijuana use is treated as a serious crime, with jail time involved, and we are spending over $7.7 million a year housing these criminals.
Well, let's go with legalized. Decriminalized, we pretty much have it decriminalized in California. It's a $100 misdemeanor ticket for an adult. It's really not a big deal. Legalized would be sold in some form, regulated. All right.
Marijuana arrests account for 46% of all drug arrests, and Americans spend $160 billion a year on the justice system.
Early, early Sunday morning, it was a pecan just uncooling. In a day, mud me a pecan, but I mean, I load them down in a photo hub.
So that's the reason why, that's just an example of the waste caused by the war on marijuana. You can point to the over 700,000 people a year that are arrested for marijuana charges. And the people in prison now serving terms for marijuana, for possession, for sale, and for getting it out. But the truth of the matter is, it's just the plan.
Money from it. They could also permit growers, making sure that the people who are trying to grow it themselves are doing it safe and bringing in some revenue. And we'd save billions by not putting people in jail for a plant.
During the last 20 years, state and local police have arrested nearly 10 million people for marijuana offenses, about 85% for possession.
At or near all-time highs. So it appears that no matter how many people we arrest, marijuana use rates continue to climb for the most part, keeping otherwise responsible adults out of jail and avoiding having a criminal record is very important.
Okay, so we cut off a lot of money going to criminals, for one. We can tax it. $40 billion on the drug war, they estimate about half of that on cannabis. So you'd save $20 billion that you're spending. It's going to be free to go after muggers and robbers and other bad people, really bad people.
As the number of people we put in jail increases, the drug use rates for marijuana have not seemed to decrease, and the popularity of the drug keeps growing. Not only would we save money on the drug war if marijuana were legalized, marijuana could bring in from $2.4 billion to $6.2 billion if it were taxed like ordinary consumer goods. So the American economy would be saving money as well as making it. The legalization would generate billions of dollars for the economy and possibly eliminate some of the national debt. The amount of resources we are wasting and missing out upon is a tremendous loss to the United States government.